Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Reptilian humanoids are a proposed race of intelligent, supernatural, or highly developed reptile-like humanoids in mythology, popular fiction, pseudoscientific theories, and in the writings of New Age conspiracists. They appear in some conspiracy theories, most notably those of Riley Martin, John Rhodes, David Icke, and in science fiction. Reptoids, a conjoined word defining reptilian humanoid beings, is the most popular name used to describe these cryptid beings, although some authors also refer to them as dinosauroids, lizard folk, or lizard men. Other names include draconians, saurians, and sauroids. They are often described as being green or gold color. Similar to the other cryptids, no one has produced proof of the existence of reptilian humanoids, and allegations of their existence can at best be referred to as cryptozoology or pseudoscience. Mythological references to reptilian humanoids. Several ancient peoples all over the world have described reptilian beings, and some have described reptilian humanoids. Common in numerous mythologies are tales of reptilian creatures, usually not humanoid, who are often, but not always, hostile to human beings. Also rather common are the myths of serpents of wisdom, who enlightened humanity before the dawn of civilization. Some individuals, doubting claims of reptilian humanoid sightings or contacts, suggest that the mythological preeminence of reptilian forms could stem from a genetic memory of instincts developed millions of years ago, when mammals were the prey of the reptiles which dominated the earth. Dreams of reptiles are often interpreted as symbolizing ancient drives and instinctive responses. The Toltec Mayan god Gutyamox was described as a serpent of wisdom who enlightened humankind. His Aztec counterpart was named Quetzalcoatl. In the Yucatan, he is called Kukulkan. The Hopi refer to a race of reptoids called the Sheti, or Snake Brothers, who live underground. The Cherokee and other Native American peoples also refer to reptoid races. In pre-Columbian mythology from Colombia, Bichu, the primordial woman, transformed into a big snake. She is also sometimes called the celestial snake, Serpiente Celestial. Many users of the drug dimethyltryptamine, the active ingredient in many South American shamanic potions such as ayahuasca, have seen reptilian humanoids or reptilian disincarnate entities and aliens while hallucinating. Europe. Cecropsi, the legendary first king of Athens, was said to have been half man, half snake. The ancient Titans and Gigantes were sometimes depicted as winged man-like beings with serpents instead of legs, for example on a fresco on a temple in Pergamum. In these images from Pergamum, some of which depict the Gigantomachy, one sees the giant Pleiades with huge serpents in place of legs. Boreas, Aquilon to the Romans, was the Greek god of the cold north wind, described by Pausanias as a winged man with serpents for legs. The European dragon dates back to ancient depictions on various archaeological artifacts. An early instance in literature was the dragon that guarded the Golden Fleece in the voyage of the Argonauts. In the Middle Ages, tales of dragons seem to have become even more common. The dragon in Europe, as a rule, was not conceived as having a humanoid form, and would not qualify as an instance of a reptilian humanoid unless explicitly described as humanoid. India. In Indian scriptures and legends, the Naga are reptilian beings said to live underground and interact with human beings on the surface. Some are alleged to turn human. In some versions, these beings were said to have once lived on a continent in the Indian Ocean that sank beneath the waves. Indian texts also refer to a reptilian race called the Sarpa. The Sarpa of India were a tribe of men with snake-like nostrils in place of noses and bandy serpentine legs. East Asia, the Chinese, Korean and Japanese speak throughout their history of El, Ying, Yang in Korean, Ryu in Japanese, or dragons, conceived of in both physical and non-physical forms, but rarely depicted in humanoid form, though they may assume a non-reptilian human form. The Japanese have tales of Kappa, a basically reptilian humanoid. In China, Korea and Japan, underwater realms where the dragon kings and their descendants live are referred to, as well as the lineage of humans from a race of dragons.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.